My brethren, I'd like to greet everyone with the peace of the Lord. I received this invitation from Pastor Ronildo, and I'm very happy to see a few of my brethren, and also there are some brethren that are watching through YouTube, and I'd like to greet everyone with the peace of the Lord Jesus. The topic of our short message tonight is in the book of Job, chapter 33, verse 4. Job 33, verse 4. And I ask the brethren, if you can, to open your Bibles on this text. Job 33, verse 4. The text says the following. The Spirit of God has made me, and the breath of the Almighty gives me life. In another Brazilian translation, it says, the Spirit of God has made me, and the inspiration of the Almighty gives me life. May the Lord bless the word that is being read. My brethren, our topic today is regarding what we have learned through these studies, through the messages, through the Sunday schools. We're going to deal with faith and life. When we speak about life, it's something that interests us, right? Especially in this moment in which the world is going through, where we observe the news. So many people, a few close to us, beloved brethren in the faith, dying because of an invisible enemy, this coronavirus that caused the world to kneel down before it. Rich and poor, powerful and simple people, doctors and common people. So the world has prostrated before a sickness like this. And for the ones who has lived a part of the 20th century like this, the world has never gone through a experience like this. And today we give great worth to life like never before. The two great wars, for whom read a little bit of watched documentaries about the two great wars of this 20th century, they saw that those wars, they took many lives, but the countries of the entire planet have never been so close to a threat to their lives like this. So it's very important to speak about life, about the topic of life. It interests us a lot. So let's go back to the history of creation of man, of the origin of man. We know that it is part of a work, of the creative work. There in Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, the word of the Lord says the following. And God has formed man from the dust of the earth and blew on his nostrils the breath of life, and man was made living soul. And in this verse, my brethren, we can observe two origins for man. The first one is very clear. The Lord has formed man from the dirt of the earth, or from this earthly life, where everything has a beginning and has an end here on earth. Or life is temporal, it's a fleeting thing. But the second origin, God blew the breath of life to his nostrils, pointing out to a different life than this earthly life. So now, when you jump from Genesis to the New Testament, we will realize that the Bible presents two expressions for the word life from the original Greek, where the New Testament was written, the koine, the popular Greek. So at least two lives. The first one that we want to speak with the brethren is bios, which means life, but doesn't mean spiritual life or a life, intellectual life. This bios that the Bible in the New Testament is referring to is related to the name, exactly what the name says, biological, a physical life, a life in the natural sense. And Jesus spoke about this life. Did you know that? In Luke 18:14, I set aside a verse that says the following. Then the one that fell amongst the thorns are the ones who heard it, heard the word. And through the days, they were being choked by the cares and the delights of life. So Jesus was speaking about the biological life, the cares, the delights, their fruits did not mature, like Jesus completes in verse 14. Chapter 18, verse 14. So the word bias mentioned here in the New Testament designates aspects of temporality. It speaks of about man. What is your time? Our time is chronos, a time that can be measured. 10 years, 20 years, 50 years. The psalmist says, teach us how to number our days. It's the biological time, it's the life of the creative work, so that we are able to reach a wise heart. So we have learned in our Sunday schools and the teaching of our church that the science in this process of scientific investigation does not consider the Word of God. Why? Because the faith, you cannot understand faith through this life, this bios. So it's impossible for you to find the origin for the answers to the word of man in this biological life and in human reason and in the faith sprouts from man's heart. But now, using reason, human reason, we will never be able to understand the origin of life because it's impossible to find God through human reason. Isn't it true? So let's continue. This word bios is also used in the New Testament to describe the period of life, the course of life, like I explained earlier in the beginning. So this word can be used in three aspects. Just out of a as a curiosity, it can mean the period of life, it can also mean the way of life, natural life, a fleeting life, with regard to our moral conduct, and also in the way of subsistence and taking care of our own personal possessions and summarizing my bread. When we speak about bias, we speak about biological life that is lived for this fleeting life, temporal life. In the time of man, like I was speaking before, our time is very short. And like the weed that sprouts in the morning, and at the end of the day, he withers and dies. When we awake, we are already old. When we begin to make account of our life, the years that we spent, we see that the time counted according to Chronos is come to its end. Soon we'll finish in our life here, forever, makes an investment for this life only. The Bible says that they are the most miserable of all creatures. Why? Because they are only thinking about the bios. They are only thinking on the chronos, on the man's time, on this temporal life. However, my brethren, the Bible also, the New Testament also presents to us a new life, which is called Zoe. This word also is a Greek word that has a beautiful and wonderful meaning. And I cannot, and of course, our Lord Jesus use this word in the Gospel of John, in chapter 10, verse 10. I think that Brandon already know it from by heart. The robber come to steal, kill, and destroy. Isn't it true? I came so that you may have life. That's true. And have it in abundance. And this life is Zoe. The word described in the original is Zoe, which means spiritual life, eternal life. So we can state that this word Zoe in the original Greek in the New Testament is completely different from bios. Zoe, the definition of this word, my brethren, is very beautiful. It says, Zoe speaks about the absolute plentifulness of life. It speaks of a life that belongs to God. See how wonderful it is. Pay attention. It's a life in an absolute sense, a life as God. As God has this life, He shares this life with us, a life that came from eternity in the person of the Lord Jesus, who is the author of life. So Zoe is complete life. We can say that it does not only encompass the biological aspects, but also the attributes connected to a new work, which is not the creative work, but yes, the redemptive work. So when we speak about Zoe, we are entering into a new time, God's time. So see the difference. Bios in the Chronos, in the man's time. Zoe is a Kairos in God's time. Bios, creative work. Zoe, redemptive work. So Paul, he knew in his experience, like we, one day, he only knew Bios. However, when Jesus revealed himself to him, he began to see the life with a new dynamics, with in a new dimension, which is the life Zoe. And he lived it in practice. He said, I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live, in the flesh I live by faith in the Son of God. So, my brother, this life that Paul speaks about now is Zoe. So, comparing the two, Bios and Zoe, temporal life with eternal life, the question is asked and is, how are we going to find the origin of life, the true plenitude of life? So we begin to see that the answer is very simple. It is in the Word of God. Only through the faith in Jesus. That's the answer. So we can, and it's possible for man to find an answer for this true origin of life and understand that God created all things in His creative work in order to reach man in the redemptive work. So to bring from eternity, Zoe, which is eternal life. So through whom? Through the Lord Jesus. Jesus came from eternity, came down from God's time, entering into man's time, Chronos, and manifested himself to the world, so that through faith in the Lord Jesus, we become participants on the life, eternal life. My brethren, Jesus is the author of life. Apostle John says, because life was manifested in him, and we saw and testify of this life, and we proclaim to you eternal life. Jesus is this who brought to us eternal life. The life that Jesus gives, he also sustained it. Jesus says, I'm the bread of life. Every time he said, spoke about this eternal life, it's Zoe. I'm the bread of life, the one whoever comes to me will never hunger. So one day we came to Jesus, my brethren, and our hunger, our thirst, it's only of the Word of God, of the eternal things. We are never thirst or hungry of the things of this world. So eternal life is the possession of the servant of God. You and I, we have this possession. Whoever does not know Jesus, and today are hearing about eternal life, they can also have this experience. You who are visiting us, you can have access to this. Maybe your life today may be focused only on this life. In the riches, in the concerns with disease, concern with the economy, in the financial side, and with everything that we also are worried about. Of course, but our focus, my brethren, is not on this biological life, in this temporal life, and our focus is in eternity, in eternal life, in our salvation, and this is what we want to share with you. Who are with us. In truth, I tell you, that said the Lord Jesus, whoever hears my word and believe in the one who sent me has eternal life and not have condemnation, but pass from death, from man's time that ends here, but to life, an eternal life, and our servants of the Lord Jesus, and with faith in Him, we have the hope in the resurrection. And this is going to take place in the rapture, my brethren. The great transformation and the great hope of the Christian is on the rapture. And if we die before the rapture, our hope will be on that day when the church, the Bible says, the dead in Christ, the ones who are saved, will resurrect first. And we, the ones who are alive, will be transformed and resurrected, will be there forever with the Lord. My brethren, our hope is eternal life. I'd like to conclude with a testimony that I heard recently in one of our transmissions, in one of our services, of a child that had leukemia, and the parents were trying to find in the world a donor that would be compared with that child. And they found, actually, they found a soldier from another country that was willing, saw the situation of that child, and made that donation out of love. And that child was perishing and about to die, but received the donation of a bone marrow. And it was, and the child was able to do the treatment and received life. The child, after being healed, my brethren, wanted to know the donor. I imagine the curiosity of the child, the desire. And the donor, of sure, surely wanted to know that child. The child didn't know who that person was. And the families communicated with each other, they scheduled a meeting, and on the day of the meeting, the child, anxious to see the donor, because they didn't know who the donor was. And soon after he appears, as soon as he appeared, the child went to him, embraced him with so much love, and would never let go of the donor. And people around it saw that the child was taking too long on this embrace, and they said, "It's all right, it's all right." And the child answered, "No, I cannot stop hugging because he gave me life. I was dying, and he gave me life." Those were the words of that child. My brethren, the life that we have today was given, was donated by the Lord Jesus. He came from eternity to give us life. And we were condemned to death because of our sins. The weight of sin is death. The free gift of the Lord is life, eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. The day in which we meet with the Lord in eternity, my brethren, oh my, how wonderful it will be. We'll be able to embrace Him as well. And I tell my brethren, I will not want to let go of this embrace because He gave me life and He can give you life tonight. May God bless us, and that those simple words may reach your heart. And the most important of all, it's not this knowledge or the words, none of it. The words in Greek or the meaning, but the application of this in your life. The temporal life ends here, and it's very quickly, but the eternal life is forever. And it has a great quality of life. May the Lord bless the brethren and bless also the church. And I'd like to share with you a revelation the Lord gave during the service. The Lord has revealed that there is a lady. She's a sister from our church. She received the news that she was going to be losing her job. What a difficult situation, isn't it true? Many are losing their jobs. And she was very anguished and desperate. But the Lord is giving her a word, and I'd like to relay this word, a revelation from the Lord. The Lord says, because you are seeking me, and because love to you, because you have definition and faithfulness to the Lord and to God's kingdom, the Lord will preserve your job. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So now let's hear a song, my brethren, and soon after we go back with the apostolic blessing.
Louvando e bendizendo ao nome do Senhor. Yeah.
Lord Jesus, my brethren, let us pray. I'd like to invite you, my beloved visitor, who are watching and through YouTube, you who are here with us, connected through Zoom. We're going to pray for you. We're going to pray for the church as well, so the Lord may renew this life, this eternal life, and this glorious hope that we have invested. This world will pass, the things will pass, but the Lord, eternal life will remain. Let's pray. Lord God, we pray for your people, making mention of the glorious power of the blood of Jesus, of this eternal life. Lord God, that you brought from your eternity to reach us, to reveal your glory to our hearts, to manifest your power. Hallelujah, we give you, Lord, for the security that we have of living eternally with you, Lord, because we understand and comprehend through the Holy Spirit that there is only eternal life in Jesus and in no other name. In no other name there is this life. And that's why we receive you as the Savior and Lord. We ask, Lord God, that the ones who don't have the Lord as their Savior, that tonight they may open their hearts and receive the Lord Jesus and enter into the path that will lead to eternal life. We praise your name, Lord, for the riches of your word. And we ask a blessing for the church in Pompano, Pastor Ronildo, Pastor Sábado, the deacons, the ushers, and the sisters, the youth, the children, intermediary and adolescents, the brethren from Texas and all the brethren who are visiting us, so that the blessing of the Lord may be upon them. And in your name we say, the wonderful grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, our Savior, the love of God, our eternal Father, and the sweet consolation of the Holy Spirit remain with you, my beloved brethren, until the glorious return of the Lord Jesus. Amen. Amen. I'd like to relay the word to Pastor Ronildo. Amen, my brethren. Pastor Jesso, thank you. Sister Ruth, it's wonderful to have you here with us. And the doors are always open. Amen. We're going to now begin. The ones who want assistance, we can find us. And the brethren can now open up your microphones and greet one another with the peace of the Lord Jesus, reminding the brethren that our next service is going to be Tuesday at 8 p.m. and also Thursday and Saturday and Sunday, always at 8 p.m. We have had visits during the week. The sisters have been doing a wonderful work of visit. The assistant groups also, groups of assistants. And this month is the month of the pastors and their family members. And I ask the brethren to continue to pray for the pastors, for the work and the ministry, so that the Lord may continue to bless Pastor Jesso. He raised his hand also. Amen. It's a blessing. for the church, when the pastors also are blessed by the Lord. Amen. When the revelation is able to reach the pastors, and then they are able to relay those revelations to the church. So I'd like to say goodbye and wish everyone the peace of the Lord Jesus. Good night, good night, brother.
Senhor Nilson.
Paz do
Senhor, Kenin.
Senhor,
carinho.
Boa noite.
Paz do Senhor,
carinho. Sábado.
Paz do Senhor, meu irmão.
Paz do Senhor, pastor.
Paz do
Senhor,
irmão.
Paz do Senhor a todos, irmão.
Paz do Senhor. Obrigado por
ter vindo. Era valoroso. Senhor,
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 irmãos,
Senhor, Senhor, Dona Creuza.